I thank again on behalf of CITU, our President of World Federation of Trade Union, for his valuable address, and he will also be addressing our delegate session also. Now we are moving a resolution. I again welcome, I have the opportunity. Comrade Samugam of LPF has already arrived, and I request him to please come on the dais. A warm welcome to him. Now the comrade, the resolution on the repeal of Citizenship Amendment Act, I think we must put an adjective before that. That most destructive and the most draconian legislation which was passed by the tyranny of majority in the parliament, the Citizen Amendment Act, and also their allied operation of NRC and NPR. The whole country is now boiling on that issue. People from every segment of society are out on the street to oppose this utterly destructive adventure of the BJP government at the center, which is specifically designed to tear apart our society, only to subserve the interest of the big capitalist class, including foreign interest, so that people don't unite and fight against their destructive exercise to ruin our nation. This is what is the implication of the fight against the Citizenship Amendment Act and the whole program behind that of the ruling class. Not merely the ruling polity, but the ruling class as a whole, to subserve their design of loot and plunder on the society. They are promoting through their political agents in the government this dangerous and destructive misadventure. So it is the responsibility of the working class to establish and bridge active link with the spontaneous struggle that is upsurging throughout the country, among the students, among the youth, among all segments of societies who are coming out in thousands, lakhs on the street against that and protesting in continuity. Even today, there are some agitations going on in at least hundreds of places in the country. That is, the working class movement has to bridge all this spontaneous struggle and develop a much more militant struggle for resistance of this draconian exercise. That is the responsibility which has fallen upon the working class. I am reading out the resolution before you, which is in your document. The 16th Conference of CITU greets the workers and other toiling and democratic sections of the people for their massive countrywide continuing protest against the Citizenship Amendment Act, NRC and NPR, inclusive of 8 January 2020 countrywide strike, workers' general strike, which also voiced the demand to repeal CAA and rejection of NCR and NPR. CAA is an assault by the BJP government on the secular foundation of the Constitution of India, which was the outcome of more than 40 years of struggle and sacrifice during the national freedom movement against the then British government's communal divisive design, communal award and partition of India. Firm opposition to and the struggle against such notorious conspiratorial design by the imperialism was the lifeline of our freedom movement, and Mahatma Gandhi was killed by the proponents and cohorts of such notoriety. CAA, the first communal act in the independent India, is in consonance with the British government's two nations theory on the basis of religion, which Indian freedom struggle never accepted, and secularism and equality became the firm foundation of the Constitution of India. Beginning in 2003, during Vajpayee government, bringing NRC in the Citizenship Act, and NPR through NRC rules, amendments of Foreigners Act in 2015, CAA is the third step, followed by NPR through house-to-house enumeration during 1st April, 30th September 2020. That is the program. These are the steps to totally subvert the Constitution towards RSS objective to establish Hindu Rashtra. The CAA is also an assault on the citizenship rights of the refugees just before or after the partition from erstwhile Pakistan for re-verification of their citizenship on the basis of proof of persecution before giving them citizenship afresh under CAA. The process of NRC and NPR is also a grave assault on the vast number of economically and socially marginalized sections of the people, including landless, rural, and urban masses, migrant workers, Adivasis, Dalits, women, for whom there may not be documents to prove their citizenship, and for the so-called doubtful failing to present the document asked for, the persons in the NPR enumeration detention camps are being established. Therefore, this conference demands immediate repeal of the CAA and rejection of NRC and NPR. 16th Conference of CITU calls upon the workers of the country to carry forward the movement uniting all other toiling and democratic sections of the people till the above demands are met. Comrade, the resolution is explanatory. We, through this resolution, we are voicing louder already the voice that has been raised spontaneously throughout the country, number one. Number two, the resolution clearly pointed out, with the passage of the Act, the matter is not over. From 1st April to 30th April, they will go house-to-house remuneration, both for the census and also for NPR. The same enumerator are being utilized by the administration to confuse the people and put them on the trap of NPR. We have to tell the people, and here lies the responsibility of our grassroots level unions, to go to house, respond to the question of census, but don't respond to the questions on NPR. They will be going with you two pro forma, one of census pro forma, another separately on NPR pro forma. We have to campaign at grassroots level to prepare the people. Only by raising noise is not enough. At the ground level, that has to be ensured that NPR ka jawab nahi denge, will not respond to the NPR questionnaires. That should be the battle cry, and working class has to organize that at the grassroots level. Then only the voice being raised louder and also covered by media in a very great way, then that louder voice will find its destination. They will be able to resist. Our task when working class, the most organized segment of the working class movement, when they take over a case, it has to go with that perfection, and our stands remain here. Our tasks remain with that. Reach house to house. Reach the unreached to expose the conspiracy of NPR and prepare the people. Not only kagaj nahi dikhayenge, will not show the papers. You need not show any paper. They will ask you a question, you have to respond. NPR respond nahi karenge, jawab nahi denge. Will not respond to NPR questions. That should be the battle cry from every hutment and household, and that task the working class movement through its primary level units has to take over. That is the basic message from this resolution. And that's why you have decided in the inaugural session itself to take over this resolution. The working class movement already reached a total unanimity. Let me remind you, on the declaration of 8 January strike, announced on 30th September 2019 in the Open National Convention, all the trade unions we are sitting over here, we jointly mentioned about NRC and gave a call to oppose NRC process. Till that time, CAA was not on the picture. And whenever CAA was enacted, within 2 days, all the central trade unions here again, sitting over here, we jointly gave a call through a state written signed statement to oppose this head-on and make this a battle cry for the 8 January strike. We have already advanced. Now the task is to go down below, reach the unreached, ensure NPR will not respond. NPR ka jawab nahi denge. These we have to ensure, and that's the message with this resolution. And I commend before you, on which the people of country have already raised their voice, commending this resolution we are adopting in advance. Thank you, comrade. With that, I promise this resolution to you.